Hey everybody, welcome to LMC Varsity Sports here on LMC TV alongside Charlie McGraw. I am Seth Rothman. Today it's high school hockey at the Hammocks Park Ice Rink, and it is time for the Section 1 playoffs as Mamaroneck takes on Clarkstown. And Charlie, this Mamaroneck team, the number one overall seed in Section 1, Division 1, an 18-1-1 regular season. They are the defending state champions, and there's a certain amount of pressure that comes with trying to defend your state title and trying to defend your number one seed if you're the Mamaroneck Tigers.
Definitely, you have to defend the number one seed here at home at Hammocks, and also, yeah, defending the state title as well. It gets started today, but this has to beat Clarkstown for the third time this year. They beat them earlier in the season twice. Once, it was only 1-0, as Tim Cavanaugh is a very good goalie. This is a very good goalie matchup as Tommy Spiro versus Tim Cavanaugh. And they only beat them 1-0 at Clarkstown at the Palisades Mall. And then today, the next time they played was 3-1. So it's very hard to beat a team 3-1. And Clarkstown's a very good 8 seed. They won 3-2 over Wrightown Harrison, and they're just a very good 8 seed. So this should be a good quarterfinal matchup.
Yeah, that 3-2 win came in the first round of the playoffs. Clarkstown was down 2-0 in that game, rallied to take the win. Mamaroneck has not lost here at the Hammocks Park Ice Rink since January of 2016. So they have been able to defend the jungle here in Mamaroneck. They'll try to do it again here in the Section 1 Division 1 quarterfinals. Opening puck drop is coming up next on LMC Varsity Sports. Defending state champions begin their journey. And they play the puck in neutral ice. It's taken there by Carducci, who swings it back behind the net. They battle for it behind, and it's taken by Clarkstown. This is Diskin who had it. Flips it up the boards, but not out. Mamaroneck able to get it back deep. This is Kim who plays it back there. Turned over to Carducci. Puck is loose and in the offensive zone and cleared out by Clarkstown. And now they're on a rush down the ice. Unable to control was Ryder. And it's taken back by the Tigers.
Good play by Nick Campbell to take it and play it forward. And he gets it again. And now he'll dump it in the zone, Seth, as we switch possession here.
A lot of dump and chase hockey early on as the Tigers go for a line change. It's kept in by Dente. And now Dente backhands it at center ice, and Clarkstown able to get it into their zone, but Mamaroneck controls. Lee goes cross ice to Campbell. Campbell up the near side, but nobody able to get to it. That's icing. A minute 10 gone by in a scoreless first period.
First icing of the game for either team. Mamaroneck is the one seed. They got a bye along with number two Suffern. And playing their second game of the playoffs is Clarkstown beat Wrightown Harrison 3-2 in the first round. 2 days later, they're playing now against Mamaroneck. So, Seth, a quick turnaround for Clarkstown.
Clarkstown able to get it deep. Knowles plays it back behind his own net. Swings it around far side, but kept in by Clarkstown. And now Dente able to clear the zone and sends the pass to LeBlanc. LeBlanc into the offensive zone, swings behind the net, gets bodied hard off the puck. It stays in. That one was deflected. The shot was taken by Lee, but it was blocked. Kept in by DeSico. DeSico sends it deeper. And Mamaroneck goes for a partial line change. Clarkstown able to get the zone exit, and they send it the length of the ice. He crossed the center ice, so no icing. Knowles reverses for Lee. Puck goes high, stays in play. Chasing it down is Freed. Harrison Freed, centering feet in front! And it was a beautiful save made by Kavanaugh.
Alamanistianu Henry with the shot on a great pass by Harrison Freed. And we said in the opening, Tim Kavanaugh is a very good goalie. And he is indeed, as he made the pad save, and it goes up. And they have to get a puck from up here, as they need a new
one left to go in the first period. Still scoreless here in Mamaroneck. The draw is won by Clarkstown, and they clear it into center ice. Alamanistianu plays it there. Now Freed loses the handle, and it's taken by Diskin, who sends it on goal. Tommy Spiro plays it aside. Alamanistianu bodied off the puck. Diskin just sends it deeper. Not much on net by either team in the first 2.5 minutes of this one. Good work there by puck retrieval by Clarkstown, but Mamaroneck able to get it back, bounce it off the boards and out. Chasing after it now is Payne. Nice work to keep hold of the puck there by Payne, and Mamaroneck gets it out into center ice, and they go in transition. This is Sullivan who loses the handle, and now Schreiber controls it, falls down, still able to get it over to Wetrova. Now Nick Campbell. Ahead it comes to Torrey. Torrey, power move right out in front. It comes, save made, rebound. I don't believe it was deflected by a Clarkstown player, and they send it the length of the ice. 11 minutes, 42 seconds left to go first period. Still scoreless in the Section 1 Division 1 quarterfinals.
Great scoring chance for James Torrey, but another good save by Tim Kavanaugh, and it's going to take something special to beat the senior here today.
Mamaroneck unable to touch up on the ice, on the offsides. So with 11:25 left to go in the period, still scoreless.
Torrey wasn't able to get a rebound as was able to be pushed aside by Kavanaugh. As Torrey's initial shot looked like maybe the rebound could have been put home, but Kavanaugh doesn't give many rebounds. If he doesn't deflect it out, he holds it. And he only gave up one goal in the one goal loss and three against the high-powering Mamaroneck offense led by Carducci, their leading scorer, Michael Carducci.
Lee sends it deep, the Seco goes chasing. Tigers able to keep it alive at the point. Big drive was blocked out in front. They're going off his own teammate. And now LeBlanc dances with it, unable to put much on that backhanded attempt. And it's taken by Clarkstown. This is Sean Coons who got bodied off. And puck came on. Nat Spiro stopped it. And now it's back out on the neutral ice. 4 minutes gone by here at Homix. As Clarkstown sends it in. This is Chris Wetrova who plays it. Reverses to Patrick Lee. Tigers able to send it back into neutral. Neither team taking a lot of chances early on, not a lot of shots. This is Wetrova. Alamanistianu. Played there by Brian Murray. Dancing with it is Alex Kim. Kim put it on goal. Spiro easily sticked it away. And it's turned over here. This is Baddick. Baddick just flips it up. It's gloved by Spiro. And he will hang on and wait for a whistle with 10 minutes and 7 seconds left to go, first period.
Spiro thought about dropping it for Nick Campbell, but with the defense coming, he wisely gloved it. It'll be a faceoff right in front of him. As three shots for Clarkstown. 4 minutes, 53 seconds gone by, and two for Mamaroneck. A couple good chances from Mamaroneck, nothing really testing the great Tommy Spiro yet. Spiro is one shutout away from tying the New York State record of 19 shutouts for a career, as he has 18, Seth.
Two of those have come against Clarkstown in the regular season, one at Homix and one up in Rockland County. That one's nearly turned over. Mamaroneck able to keep control. Schreiber tried finding Carducci, but instead Clarkstown takes possession, and now Mamaroneck goes chasing. This is Torrey going after it. Could not get there. Puck is off the boards, kept in for the moment, and finally cleared by Clarkstown. 5.5 gone by, scoreless first period in the quarterfinals of the Section 1 playoffs. Tigers enter the zone cleanly. This is Payne. And now Clarkstown takes over. Alex Kim quickly through neutral. Kim dances around the defender. That was Wetrova. And Wetrova able to get the puck away from him.
Kim's a fast skater, Seth.
Here comes Carducci. He's a power forward. tries getting it out in front. Nobody able to get a stick on it. James Torrey was in the vicinity, but it's kept alive by Latrova, who flings it on net. It's stopped by Kavanaugh, who gets the faceoff.
Latrova with a long shot there is easy save for Kavanaugh.
Not much testing both goalies yet. A couple early chances from Mamaroneck was the best chances we saw. But so far, even keel game, and 8:49 to go in this first period. We'll see if either team can get on the board here.
Mamaroneck trying to keep it alive on the far side boards, hops over with Trova's stick, and it goes down into the Tigers' defensive end right in front of the Mamaroneck student section. Knowles, near side, tries flipping it to LeBlanc. LeBlanc, his pass fortunate to get through to Dente, but Dente loses it, and Jared Slattery played it. Now Teddy Knowles has it. Coons battling for it, but it's taken back by Mamaroneck. 8 minutes, 10 seconds left to go, scoreless first period, and it's flipped ahead now to Brian Murray. Clarkstown enters the zone, sticked away by Spiro. Callahan goes after it. That shot was taken by Murray. It was well wide, and it's flipped out by the Tigers. No icing on the play. Clarkstown plays it. This is Brian Murray as Mamaroneck goes for a line change. And Tigers now possess it in their own end. The defending state champions, a defense-first philosophy. And their defensive game has been excellent all season. Tommy Spiro, the goaltender, as Charlie said a moment ago, a long part of that. As Mamaroneck trying to get into the offensive zone. Good work right at the blue line. And a player lost his stick. No penalty called on that. And Mamaroneck will enter as Clarkstown is changing. Up it comes for Freed. Good defensive work there by Clarkstown. But now they try to move in transition. This is Ryder. Ryder loses the handle. Good defense by Mamaroneck. Halfway, just past the halfway mark of period number one. It's turned over to Robbins. And out of the zone it comes. Flipping it in was Kyle Ryder. But there's Will Payne. Payne goes off the boards. It stays in the zone momentarily. And now Mamaroneck able to flip it ahead for Alaminastianu. He's battling for it and flips it deeper as Mamaroneck changes. 6 minutes, 30 seconds left to go. First period, still scoreless.
They didn't credit a shot that before that Mamaroneck took.
Ryder into the offensive zone. Not much speed to it. Flips it out in front. Nobody was there. Robbins on goal. Save made by Spiro. And Mamaroneck able to corral it.
So it's
Tigers
been a while.
Quickly in transition. Schreiber lost the handle. Lee sends it in. And nothing doing for Mamaroneck. This is Knowles ahead for Carducci. One touched into the zone. But it's taken away by Clements. And Clements sends it into his offensive end. With 9 minutes gone by in the first period. Tigers quickly moving in transition. It was taken away from Carducci. They battled for it there. And, boy, a little dangerous play by Knowles as Sean Coons was in on the play. But Mamaroneck escapes it and get it out. This is Schreiber ahead for Torrey. Torrey into the zone, whiffed on the shot. Puck is loose. It's taken by Clarkstown, and they're able to clear. Two on two comes Clarkstown. This is Clement, who flips it wide of Tommy Spiro. As we approach 10 minutes gone by in a very quickly paced first period, which has had very few whistles. Torrey bodied off the puck, unable to retrieve it, but Carducci does. It was touched by Lee. Spiro played it right to a Clarkstown player. That shot whistled wide from Robbins. They battle right out in front. They score! Clarkstown on the board first. 4:50 left to go in the first period.
Wow, a rare mistake by Tommy Spiro as he passed it right to Clarkstown. Then they pressured. They dumped behind the goal. It went there. And getting the goal will be number 17. That was Kyle Ryder, assistant captain, assisted on the shot by Riku Robbins. And Tommy Spiro, rare mistake by him, as when he passed it out,
Clarkstown got it. They played it wide of him and just like a tap goal past him on the rebound.
So that's the first goal Clarkstown has scored in three games against Mamaroneck this season. As Clarkstown, six of the game's first eight shots unofficially on the scoreboard. And now Mamaroneck is trying to play catch up here at the Homics Park Ice Rink. This is Sean Coons who gets it out of the zone. It's played there by Mamaroneck, flipped ahead for LeBlanc. LeBlanc tried sending it in the zone. It was blocked by a Clarkstown defender. Big hit, Jared Slattery took it from Dente. And now Payne dancing in behind the net, trying to center one out in front. Covering it up was Kavanaugh after Connor LeBlanc tried backhanding one, shoveling one on goal.
Technically, actually, they give the shot now. Technically, that's the first shot from Mamaroneck in a while, so that's about 10 minutes as either way, but it was Clarkstown who got the goal and the fortunate bounce off the back thing, but we need...
Tigers win the draw. LeBlanc finagles it deeper, and Dente tried getting to it. He was not able to get there, and Mamaroneck able to send it back in. Playing it there was Diskin. Kept in briefly by Mamaroneck. They're able to keep it in again. That was Nick Campbell right on the blue line. And Clarkstown sends it the length of the ice. It's on goal, so Spiro plays it. That turned over, though, as Clarkstown back into the offensive end. Alamon Estiano off the bench. Gets some contact and plays it to a teammate. Nearly turned over as Murray was right in on that one. And now Will Payne backhands it in neutral ice. Mamaroneck really not connecting on its passes here in the first period. We're nearly 12 minutes in. Tigers have unofficially four shots. In comes Clarkstown. That one got deflected. Freed off the bench. Unable to get to it, but it's icing. Freed would have been the first one to it, but in high school hockey, it's an automatic icing.
Yeah, different rules in the NHL, and that hurt Mamaroneck there, as that was like a cherry-pick play, as he came right off the bench, like when you see guys come right out of the penalty box, instead right off the bench, and the rules were different like they are in the NHL, that would have been a perfect play, but instead it was too long.
That shot, Spiro made a save through traffic. Alex Kim put it on net from the blue line and it got through all the traffic. Clarkstown still with it. That shot attempt by Ryder whistled wide and Mamaroneck able to play it and they send it out into neutral ice. This is Alex Kim who is being hounded by Sullivan. Clarkstown still with it. Ryder's shot was blocked aside by Spiro and he covers and a very quick whistle as the puck may have been loose. 2:31 left to go first period and right now it's all Clarkstown here at Omix.
Yeah, by the way they're playing right now, it looks like Clarkstown's the number one seed, the team that went 18-1-1, as where it's actually Mamaroneck. And Clarkstown is making Mamaroneck's rust show as they haven't played in a week.
You know, we spoke with Coach Mike Schiaparelli before the game and his big concern was that first period. It was trying to get out of that first period. It is very nerve-wracking to play a Section 1 playoff game when you know if you lose, your season is over. And that first playoff game is always the hardest one. Clarkstown's already had that game. Mamaroneck has not. That gives Clarkstown a little bit of an advantage early in this game. They've taken that advantage so far because Mamaroneck has looked a little bit nervous in the early going here. 2 minutes left to go in the first period. And the Tigers really getting nothing going offensively. This is now Carducci, who could not get it up to Schreiber. And it's taken by Jared Slattery. Slattery quickly into the offensive zone. His shot was blocked by Giroux. And Mamaroneck flips that into center ice. It's set right back in. Clarkstown goes for a line change. Minute 35 left to go, first period. Ahead it comes to Schreiber. Good pass ahead to Torrey. Flipped it out in front. That shot whistled wide from Schreiber. Another opportunity is loose in the crease. And Clarkstown is able to clear it out. Big open ice hit. But Clarkstown has it. This is Bauman who sent it in with a minute 10 left to go in the period. And now Campbell plays it. and flips it out of play with 1:04 left to go in the first period.
The only category Mamaroneck's beating Clarkstown in is the hit category. They're out hitting them by about double, but on the scoreboard, 1-0. And that was a good scoring chance there for the Tigers. Best of the game probably for Kavanaugh. Nothing he couldn't handle. And Clarkstown coach Rick Willows thought that that was possibly a penalty on that hit, but it looked like it was probably clean.
Might have been head contact, but it looked like it was a full body hit right off the face off. The shot was whistled wide by Slattery. And Mamaroneck able to get to it. Now this is LeBlanc. LeBlanc through neutral in the offensive zone, stops and feeds it out in front to DeSico. DeSico swings around, could not get it to his teammate Dente, and Clarkstown able to clear. 45 seconds left in the first period. Boy, a little bit sloppy there from Will Payne, but he survives that as Mamaroneck plays it. 35 seconds left to go. DeSico turns it over. This is Ryder. Good body position by Campbell to get to it first. Now Payne, 25 seconds left in the first period. Payne quickly through neutral. Back to LeBlanc, who was bodied off it. And Clarkstown flips it out of play with 14.7 seconds left in the first period.
You'll have to get a new puck and put it in play. That is not delay a game in high school hockey. It would have been in NHL rules. Bottom line, you get a face-off right in front of the Clarkstown goal from Mamaroneck with 14.7 and a good scoring opportunity if you win this face-off set to tie it at 1 at the end of 1.
So the face-off is scrummed. It's kicked ahead by Mamaroneck. Centering fade out in front and unable to get a stick on it was Torrey. The puck was bouncing over the stick of Campbell. Sparrow plays it right to a defender and blocking it away was Mamaroneck's Payne. My goodness, that could have been bad as Clarkstown had that opportunity. But Mamaroneck just able to send it away from danger. That was Clemens who nearly had that chance. It was Ryder who nearly had that chance. Anyways, Tigers trail 1-0 after 1 on LMC Varsity Sports.
Back here on LMC Varsity Sports, alongside Seth Rothman, I'm Charlie McGraw, and much different start than we thought, Seth.
Yeah, you know, again, I mean, this is something that Mike Schiaparelli says before every playoff run, no matter what sport he's coaching. That first playoff game is extremely difficult. Mamaroneck came out looking a little bit tense. Hopefully they do go a little bit free and easier here in this second period.
So we'll see what we get as the two have changed sides. And they cut the ice during the first and second periods, as having it now will be Nick Campbell. He'll play it behind his own net to Freed, that was Will Payne, and now it'll go ahead with Torrey. Torrey dumps one towards the goalie, Kavanaugh, and he'll push it away easily to Kim. Kim lost it, though. It was Schreiber, but getting it back is the speedster Alex Kim as he plays it forward now for Clarkstown. Riku Robbins has it, and as he had the assist on that first goal to Kyle Ryder, and Spiro is able to poke check it away, and he got it back to Robbins. Now Payne has it, and over to Carducci. Carducci has it out of Torrey. Torrey shoots, kicked away, shot, and it scores! Harrison Schreiber, assist to James Torrey, will get the...
And that's a lot better, Charlie, because that's what we were talking about earlier, which is that they needed to play a little bit free and easier. They needed to feel like they were into this game. And now right off the bat here in the second period, 1:10 into it, they tie the game. And that is much more in line with what Mamaroneck needed.
And it's a sophomore sensation, Harrison Schreiber, who puts it home past Kavanaugh after the assist on the rocket shot that was rebounded, taken by James Torrey. Will Payne passed it to Torrey, so Payne gets the first assist, second assist to Torrey, and Schreiber gets the goal
13:45 left in the second. So 1 minute, 15 seconds in, Mamaroneck ties it at one. And whatever Coach Schiaparelli said in that locker room had to fire him up, Seth.
Yeah, and again, you know, that's part of postseason hockey, is learning to deal with the ebbs and the flows. In a regular season game, you know, the game is a chapter, right? In a postseason game, every period is a chapter. And I think we saw that first period, the chapter was not very good for Mamaroneck. And now I think we're starting to see the Tigers play a little bit more of the way that they normally play.
As this one is won by Mamaroneck as a face-off in their own zone. And Clarkstown plays it forward here. And it'll be played by the Tigers after getting it back. It was Patrick Lee, and he played it to DeSico. DeSico played it to LeBlanc, and it squirts around and goes behind the goal and played up by Clarkstown and intercepted by Patrick Lee. Play forward by the defender, Teddy Knowles. And now Clarkstown will play it behind the goal on a hit by DeSico that takes out the much smaller Brian Callahan. And Lee tries to play it forward, intercepted at mid-ice by Clarkstown, played up by Knowles to free. No icing as it went off the middle boards as it's waved off by the official. And Alan Menestiano has it here as we 3 minutes gone by now, 18 minutes in this game gone by of penalty-free hockey. No penalties on either team yet. As this one will be played through.
Yeah, you know, you talk about that, Charlie. This is a Mamaroneck team that has not always been known as a team that avoids penalties.
A great save there. And a penalty coming in now.
Well, there you go.
As it looks like it was a roughing or something against Clarkstown's captain, Michael Diskin.
What happened there was Diskin, after the play, was given an extra cross check to the Mamaroneck player. They call it holding, but he was given a couple extra cross checks there after the play went kind of ended, and the referees had no choice but to call the penalty. And so now the Mamaroneck power play has a chance to get the Tigers the lead.
Right on cue, we're talking about no penalties in the game. But like you said, a team, yeah, that does get a lot of, as Schreiber gets a shot off and he roofed it just high off the glass, and it goes right to his teammate, Will Payne. So we see the Mamaroneck power play unit get to work. Carducci's shot is blocked by Kavanaugh, and Shriver's rebound can't go home as it's knocked away by the penalty kill of Clarkstown, but kept in by Mamaroneck, and Payne has it here. To Carducci, back to Payne. Actually, Payne lets it go through to Campbell, to Payne. Minute and a half in high school hockey for a power play, so 32 seconds gone by as Kavanaugh gets a faceoff.
What we're seeing from Kavanaugh, who's now made 5 saves in this period, very positionally sound goaltender, very square to the puck at all times, and we saw that with that cross-crease save that he made a moment ago.
And a big face-off win by Clarkstown, but they can't clear. It's kept in by Carducci. His shot is just wide of Kavanaugh. This one is cleared finally by Clarkstown. First clearing of the power play, and there's 42 seconds remaining on the Mamaroneck first power play of the game. As Carducci resets, same guys have been in for this power play that started it, and it looks like this is their number one team in there, their power play unit. Actually, it's more offensive than they usually have. As this one's Spiro, and you don't want to get a hold. You don't want to hold it in a face-off on when you have a power play, and he's able to keep it in play as Payne gets it here. So that's a cardinal sin of hockey, to stop the play when the other team's on a power play, as Spiro starts to count down the end of the power play. And out of the box now, and staying in will be the captain, Michael Diskin, as the box is a little screwed up there, the door on a hinge or something. And so we're back to 5-on-5.
Following the holding penalty on Diskin.
And Carducci skates forward and he hit hard. And now they're finally able to close the door.
That's a pretty dangerous thing. I mean, that's how guys can get hurt, is if they get hit into a door that's open. So good thing they were able to close it.
And the shot, it goes off of Kavanaugh.
So it was Schreiber who took it looking for a second goal.
But yeah, and the way these guys are hitting, that's definitely a possibility.
As this one is played forward by Lee
behind the goal. As Mamaroneck has all the momentum now. It was 10-4 entering the period. It's now 11-10. Shots by Clarkstown. Offsides called on Clarkstown.
Yeah, so Tigers have 6 of the period, 7 shots. And, again, listen, they're the number one seed. They're the defending state champions. They're one of the best teams in the state. They expect a deep run into this postseason. And so I think if you're Mamaroneck, you expect a period like this. And that first period, I think, again, nerves a little bit difficult. And now Mamaroneck in a tie game. So you still got to be careful here if you're the Mamaroneck Tigers. But you certainly like what you've seen so far in the second period.
As DeSico has it here, played back to Lee. Lee plays it forward, and this one will go through. No icing, as it was deflected by Max Plonsker, getting some ice time now. And it'll be intercepted by Watrove. Actually, goes right to him. And Plonsker and LeBlanc chase. Nice pass there to Robbins, who had the assist on the Clarkstown goal, and he gets a nice shot off and a save made by Tommy Spiro.
You know, and the thing about postseason hockey, and listen, we're gonna talk about it all game because this is the story tonight, is in postseason hockey, sometimes you can become scared to make a mistake, right? And this is a situation where you need to play free and easy. If you're playing hockey scared, you're not gonna play hockey well. I think Mamaroneck was playing scared in that first period. They were playing a little bit pensive, and I think they've been much better here in this first 7 minutes of this second period.
Yeah, and it was a rare mistake by Tommy Spiro, the pass that was intercepted by Clarkstown that led to the goal, as icing is waved off as it goes around. And this one will be played, intercepted by Alamenestiano. Big hit here, out of play, and
I think there was a little bit of concern for Freed. I think he might have went head first into the boards, and he does get up looking. I think he's looking okay, but I think they want him to go off the ice anyway. Yeah, they did say that he had a little bit of head contact, and so the referees will usher him off the ice, and he's going to have to get checked out before being allowed back in. So anytime there's a player who is suspected to have a potential head injury or head contact, play immediately stops, and he did go very heavily into the boards.
As they'll get a line change anyway, so he'll come out, but a safety concern. And good call by the ref to stop play. He was a defenseless player against the boards right in front of the goal, and you don't want somebody accidentally stepping on him or something.
Right, and again, that's part of the new age of hockey, is we learn more about head injuries and trying to make sure that everybody stays protected, and so referees have to be extremely mindful and perhaps even over-cautious just in the case.
As back to hockey, and Clarkstown has it here on the far side, 7-10 remaining. That shot is blocked by Carducci nearly. I don't know how that didn't go in the bench.
It went off the top of the boards. Clarkstown's bench thinks it hit a guy on the bench. It sounded like it went off the top of the boards and ricocheted back into play. Either way, face off with 7:08 left in the second period.
So they stop play because of that, and coming back in will be another line change from Mamaroneck. So it'll be won by Clarkstown's Dean Bauman. And he brought it in, but wide of the net. Clarkstown has a 12-10 advantage in shots on goal, but a 1-1 after Harris and Schreiber tied it 1:15 into this period, assisted by Will Payne and James Torrey. Torrey had the first assist, second assist by Payne.
So Mamaroneck will play it forward here.
And back to Kim, Alex Kim. Kim cutting through the defense, shot saved by Spiro. It might have been just wide as well. And that shot is blocked by Campbell laying out. And that one is wide of the goal mouth. Little pressure here by Clarkstown. And Spiro with the glove save.
Interesting, Charlie, to watch this Mamaroneck team, because in previous years you would always see guys flying the zone and the Mamaroneck gets the puck. You would always see guys in front of the puck. Now it almost seems like everybody's behind the puck and the puck is sort of leading the offensive rush. Very interesting. It's obviously a much more defensive mindset. It's very interesting to watch the way this Mamaroneck team has changed over the last 3 to 4 years.
Meanwhile, the Tigers about to go on the penalty kill.
It
was a tripping call against Dente. So Clarkstown gets its first power play.
I know there's no clipping in hockey, but the way he said it, as Clarkstown gets their first power play and their first shot on the power play is saved. It's Michael Diskin, who actually served him penalty earlier, takes the shot as it is cleared forward. Obviously, no icing.
By the way, Dente is serving the penalty. The actual penalty was on Spiro.
Oh, a tripping on Tommy Spiro. Good pickup by Steven Saputo, our cameraman. As that does happen.
So,
Dente serving the tripping by the goalie, Tommy Spiro.
Look out.
That one was close to us, wow.
Charlie was looking down there for a second. He wasn't looking at the puck.
I was looking down. Seth says, look out, and I see the puck coming. But luckily, Seth, it was short of me. I would have really had to look down. I would have really had to get in the way of it.
So 47 seconds left. Clarkstown getting some good looks on their power play as Mamaroneck is trying to get the kill.
Carducci will lose the faceoff. As Seth said, 45 seconds, now 40 seconds of counting on the power play for the Clarkstown combined team of Clarkstown North and Clarkstown South. They put their rivalry aside in other sports to make this combo hockey team. Those two, Clarkstown South. They have the Clarkstown South colors, more or less. Actually, no, Clarkstown North colors. Clarkstown South has some purple in them. Clarkstown North, I believe, is these colors. As this one will, penalty about to expire. Spiro with a last second lunge is able to save a possible shot by Robbins, and that was closer than it looked.
It was deflected on Spiro, and he had to be really alert. It was a good thing that his pad was flush on the ice. Otherwise, it might have trickled through him. So 2 seconds left on the Clarkstown power play, and a really alert save there by Tommy Spiro.
And the goalie's stick is broken. Kavanaugh's stick is broken.
What he was trying to alert the referees because he needs a new stick. And now a little bit of confusion over here as Kavanaugh waits for a new stick.
I think he broke it when he was trying to hit it to alert that there was a penalty. So he gives it to the official and he'll get a new stick. That's had to be what happened. He was trying to alert that there was a penalty, that the penalty was expiring.
Meanwhile, they don't appear to have another goalie stick. Now has to use a regular stick.
No, instead of stick. He's using the backup's goalie stick. Another goalie, the same goalie stick that he had, he doesn't have a backup of that. So he has to use the goalie who actually has to stay in the penalty box. because there's not enough room on the bench. Number one, the backup, Matthew Lambros. They have three goalies. He has to use his stick. So they'll use a goalie stick, just a different, not the exact one that Kavanaugh had. So a different model. And it's belonging to the back of a Lambros. We're back in play. We'll see how that'll affect them, but he'll stop it.
Regardless, it doesn't look like a normal goalie stick. It looks a little bit smaller than a regular goalie stick. But anyways, back at the ranch, 4:13 left to go here in the second period. Still tied, 1-1 at the Hymens Park ice rink. And now we are another whistle, and now they've gotten Kavanaugh's backup stick again.
Hashtag stick problems.
Yeah, we're having a few stick issues here, Hamix.
Oh, yeah, because that's for, like, the younger kid. That goalie, their backup goalie is a lot smaller.
Right,
Seth. So that's like a goalie. A stick you would use since you're smaller, and a stick I would use is the one he has.
I'm just not going to comment on that. We got a game going on here, Charlie.
You know what I mean. But, yeah, but a game, and they have a lot of problems with the stick. And as it'll be played here by Clarkstown. They'll bring it forward. 3:50 remaining in this second period. 1-1 game. A goal late in the first period with 5 minutes left by Kyle Ryder. Got the scoring started for Clarkstown. And then 1 minute 15 seconds into this one, as this one is in front. And Spiro is able to put it aside. The game was tied up by Harrison Schreiber. Playing forward to the man, Schreiber. And he gets through two defenders, and another one, shot, is wide, near side. Back to Knowles, Teddy Knowles.
Diskin a little bit slow to get up there, but he stays on the ice.
Carducci has it. Carducci, the leading scorer from Mamaroneck, hasn't had that many scoring chances in this one, as they've kept him at bay. Again, third time these two teams are meeting. Mamaroneck won 1-0 and 3-0. 1-0 at the Palisades Ice Rink, the home rink of the Clarkstown team, and a great glove save by Spiro on the save by Riku Robbins. That was one of his best saves of the day.
Yeah, really good work there by Clarkstown to get the open look. And listen, Spiro's been really, really sharp. He's made 15 saves on 16 shots unofficially. Really, really good performance so far from the senior Mamaroneck goaltender.
Both goalies are seniors, Tim Kavanaugh and Spiro. And they take the captain off the ice here, Bauman, assistant alternate captain. As this one is won by Mamaroneck's Carducci, back to Schreiber. Schreiber plays to Big James Torrey. Torrey dumps it in front, behind the goal, and where Carducci will fight for it with two players, and Carducci falls down. Schreiber chases it, trying to keep it in the zone, and they barely do. That does Torrey. Carducci skates after it. He has it now. He has Torrey and a good pass, but an even better stick choked by Kevin Stosh. And the Clarkstown bench wanted a penalty, but instead it was just a nice hit by Mamaroneck. As Carducci's stick keeps this one in the zone, and he gets one, and he shoots, and he scores!
Well, that was more just kind of a broken play, and Carducci was able to wrist it home high to give Mamaroneck the lead.
What a play by Michael Carducci as he knocked it down unassisted, as he knocked it down in the air, basically assisted himself as he knocked it up in the air and rolled down, and Carducci just slapped it by Kavanaugh. Unbelievable play, and it's 2-1.
Sometimes you'd rather be lucky than good, and I think Mamaroneck was lucky on that one, but hey, two goals here in the second period. They take a 2-1 lead, and back on the offensive again.
Historically, the second period has been Mamaroneck's best period. As this one is played behind the goal by Lee. Lee plays it forward, and as there's 1:27 remaining. Mamaroneck just taking the 2-1 lead on the great play by Carducci, who knocked it high in the air and then it bounced around and got as the play, and he's beat Kavanaugh
with a
perfect shot. Mamaroneck looking to add their lead in the final 1:10 near the Clarkstown goal. The backhand is intercepted by Clarkstown, and now they'll bring it up and try and tie it up as we are at the 1 minute mark of this final, of this second period, excuse me. Of course, one period remains. And Kim skating fast is stolen, and a long shot taken and saved by Kavanaugh. The Mamaroneck still trailing in the shots on goal department. 16-12, Clarkstown edge. Ooh. This one is blocked and a huge hit. As the two met there, that was a scary play, as Seth grimaced to. And this one is in front of Spiro. And Riku Robbins.
Mamaroneck's got to be careful to close this period out right now. A little bit sloppy in the defensive end right there, and it very nearly cost them.
15 seconds now, actually 10 seconds. And it's dumped towards the goal, and this is a good play for Mamaroneck, as it'll be almost impossible for Clarkstown to get something going with 2 seconds left, and the period will come to an end. And that was a hit after the whistle, no call, as the coach, Rich Willows, didn't like that, but it's 2-1. Mamaroneck leads Clarkstown after a 2-goal period. So we'll be right back with the third period here on LMC Varsity Sports.
We are back here at the Homex Park Ice Rink for the start of period number 3. Mamaroneck, the number 1 seed in the Section 1 Division 1 playoffs, holding a 2-1 lead over Clarkstown. Puck is down, away we go. Carducci lost the draw. Clarkstown flings it into their offensive end. Back forth, there's Mamaroneck's Payne. Gets it up to Schreiber, who played it. And now Schreiber tried getting it in, but it stopped there by Clarkstown. This is Kim, who played it. And now Campbell chops it off the boards. Clarkstown comes away with it, and a penalty upcoming on Mamaroneck as Riku Robbins got tripped down to the ice. And 30 seconds into the third period, Clarkstown will go on the power play.
Obvious tripping against James Torrey, and he'll head to the penalty box. So it'll be a minute and a half power play for Clarkstown. Third power play of the game. No power play goals for either team. Second power play of the game for Clarkstown. So an obvious tripping call against Torrey 30 seconds in. That's not what you wanted if you're Mamaroneck.
Kim played it along to Ryder. Ryder near side corner. They dig for it. It's taken by LeBlanc, who backhands it out of the zone. Clarkstown and Mamaroneck go chasing after it. This is DeSico, who tried getting it out in front, but it's taken there by Clarkstown, and they move in transition. That pass unsuccessful, and LeBlanc sends it the length of the ice. Minute gone by in the power play. Rather, 30 seconds gone by in the power play. Minute gone by in the period. Clarkstown trailing by a goal here in the Section 1 quarterfinals. As they send it around, took a weird bounce, a weird carom off their boards. But Clarkstown able to keep it in as Bauman played it. But Clarkstown unable to get solid possession. That one, clearing attempt was whiffed. And diving to try to keep it in was Diskin. No penalty called on that.
The ref didn't see it. Looked like it could have been a boarding.
Robbins into the zone. Out in front it comes. That shot whistled over the crossbar. But Clarkstown able to briefly keep it alive. It finally comes out. And Shane Murphy will play it.
10 seconds left on the power play.
And Clarkstown unable to get anything cooking. Mamaroneck sends it out. Carducci was waiting in neutral. Gets it over to Freed. Freed into the offensive zone. Swings it back to Carducci. Power play over. Carducci behind the net. Gets bodied off the puck nicely. And it comes out into neutral ice. This is Harrison Freed. Spins for Knowles. And a whistle stops play. I believe the puck must have gone out of play, I believe. So it will be a face-off
Not sure what that whistle was for. In fact, either way, it's a face-off in the Clarkstown offensive end. The draw is clean. It's won by Mamaroneck, swung around the boards by Knowles. Now Torrey played it. Chipped by Carducci. He was unable to get it out, apparently. And now Mamaroneck has it. This is Schreiber. Schreiber into the offensive zone, just sends it deeper. 2.5 gone by, third period. Tigers lead 2-1. Schreiber kept it alive. Out in front it comes to Carducci. Back to Knowles at the point. He whips it around the boards. Back behind, Schreiber threw one out in front. Nobody was there. Puck comes out of the zone. Knowles goes chasing.
It's Clarkstown's Jared Slattery. He lost a glove on that play. He was defending with only one glove.
And Mamaroneck was called for offsides with 11:58 left to go in the third period.
See all kinds of equipment issues with Clarkstown, with the goalie stick, now the glove, and before losing a stick was Callaghan. So interesting enough. I mean, these things happen in hockey, but not that much.
Shots in the second period were 8-6 Mamaroneck, 16-12 for the game in favor of Clarkston. Should say of Clarkstown, not of Clarkston. Clarkston's a college up in northern New York. Clarkstown has it now. That shot was gloved by Spiro on the shot that was taken by the senior forward, Dean Bauman.
Of course, Clarkstown, a combination of Clarkstown North and Clarkstown South team. The two schools, as it's a combined team, as many hockey teams in Section 1 are, as they just beat Rytown Harrison, which is Rye and Ryneck and Blindbrook.
Diskin might have had a shot attempt there. Instead, he wins it around the boards. They battle forward in the corner. It's taken by Clarkstown. Back to Diskin. Diskin plays it deeper. Back behind it comes. Campbell gets to it first. And Mamaroneck able to take control. The man had gotten away with a hold as well. Up it comes. LeBlanc takes it from Dente. LeBlanc whips it and a kick save made, and the rebound might have been loose. It's cleared by Clarkstown.
Kavanaugh didn't know where it was. It was right under him.
Spiro sticks that one aside. Campbell plays it. 4 minutes gone by, third period. Still plenty of time left in this one as Dente chips it in. Diskin wheels around the net with it. Coons backhands it out of the zone. But now Mamaroneck will have to chase it into their own zone. Lee played it there. Taken away by Clarkstown. Centering feet out in front, and nobody was there for Clarkstown.
That all started from a sloppy back pass off the stick of Wachroba.
Puck pops up in the air. It's taken by Mamaroneck. That's Alamon Estiano who played it. They battle for it right in front of center ice. Wachroba gets it cross ice. That shot was a save made by Kavanaugh on the drive by Sullivan.
Yeah.
10 minutes, 13 seconds left to go in the regulation. Winner of this game will play either North Rockland or White Plains in the Section 1 semifinal. Mamaroneck 18-1 and 1 on the season. But they are unblemished here at Comex, trying to keep their perfect record alive here at home as the faceoff is battled for. Backhand save made by Kavanaugh, and the rebound pops out behind the nets taken by Clarkstown. 5 minutes gone by, third period, and Stush plays it, gets it into the offensive zone, backhands it behind the net, but it's taken there by Wachroba. Out to the point it comes. That was a big drive that was taken by Murphy, but it hit nothing but the backboards. And now they battle for it at center ice. Schreiber battling there. It's taken by Robbins. Robbins, nice defensive work there by one of the captains, Carducci. They battle behind the net. Puck is loose into the corner. Jumping to get it was Lee. Nearly turned over by Mamaroneck. Wachroba battling. Robbins in as well. And Wachroba finally able to swing it over to Torrey. Nice one-touch pass to get it ahead to Carducci. 2-on-1 if they hurry. Carducci, good. Back-checking there by Clarkstown. And they're able to clear into center ice. This is Campbell. Campbell bounced it off the referee, and Clarkstown able to take it, and they have an odd man rush. 3-on-2 for Clarkstown, and an excellent stick work there by Mamaroneck. That was Will Payne, who was in the right place at the right time. Just over 6 minutes gone by, third period, still 2-1 Tigers. That one turned over right in the slot, and Clarkstown was unable to keep it in. That was Michael Diskin, who nearly had the chance. 8 minutes, 38 seconds left in the third period. Still 2-1 Tigers.
It was just offsides, was Diskin. Good call by the official. And Mamaroneck's bench alerted him of that as well. But Clarkstown had a couple chances, but Mamaroneck's defense is playing very well, as they should. If they could get one more goal, definitely put the pressure off of them. As 8:30 remaining in this one.
The battle, so much of this game has been on neutral ice, as Baddick able to send it in, but again, nobody there for Clarkstown on the dumping. Now he's able to swing it back again, and Mamaroneck able to get to it, but that shot was whistled well wide from Diskin. Baddick played it, puck popped up in the air, Baddick plays it again, nobody there. And Payne able to take control. 7 minutes gone by, third period. Puck in neutral ice, nearly taken there by Dente. Instead, it's Campbell who plays it in neutral, and Campbell dumps it in. Clarkstown first two, and on the defensive end, battling is DeSico. Payne unable to keep it in, but Payne able to keep possession, which is important because he was being hassled by Riku Robbins. Halfway through the third period. One goal game in the Section 1 quarterfinals. Both teams playing very careful, deliberative hockey. This is Dente. Dente avoids the check. And Clarkstown is able to clear, and that should be icing. Nope, they wave it off, no icing. 7:07 left to go, third period. That one's turned over though, and unable to get a clean shot attempt was Bauman. Back to the point it comes. Clarkstown plays it along the far side wall. Good body work there by DeSico to play it ahead for Henry Alamanestiano. Alamanestiano tries getting it ahead for Dente. He could not complete the pass. Puck bounced over his stick, and it leads to an icing with 6:44 to go in regulation.
Interesting call by the official not to call icing over there on the previous play, and then that goes for an icing, but I guess it's all on the read of the defender and who's around the puck. But nevertheless, it'll be an offensive opportunity for Clarkstown with not many remaining, as there's only 6:40 to go now.
Clock continues to tick. 2 second period goals, the difference for Mamaroneck. Alamanestiano into the offensive zone. Alamanestiano into the corner, centering feed, they score! It's 3-1! So the centering feed to Harrison Freed from Henry Alamanestiano. Mamaroneck leads 3-1 with 6:28 left in regulation.
And it's the pass that made the play, as it was a great pass from Henry Alamanestiano. As just the one assist goes to Alamanestiano, and Harrison Freed beats the goalie Kavanaugh five hole. And now it's 3-1, and that's a huge goal for Mamaroneck, as they have a two goal lead with time on their side, as there's only 6:15 remaining as the ref falls down.
And he got hit by the puck as well. That was a brilliant pass by the senior Alamanestiano to find Harrison Freed. And Mamaroneck's got a two-goal lead and a little bit of a cushion with now 6 minutes left to go. And they send it in. So Clarkstown now tied, no longer their friend. Michael Diskin played it. Mamaroneck still trying to battle for it. It's Sullivan behind the net, is one of the guys back there, and they stop play.
They were too close to the net. They stopped play as the puck went up on it, and there'll be a face-off in the neutral zone. As Mamaroneck 5:46 away from advancing to the Class Division One semifinal as they are the defending Division One state champion.
They've got that huge banner in the corner of the ice, and the side that Clarkstown is chasing, it's actually right in their vision as they try and upend the defending state champions. Schreiber over to Carducci. Carducci in the offensive end tried centering on it, deflected wide. They go chasing for it in the near side corner. Battling for it there is Torrey and Schreiber, and it's turned over right to Carducci. Wrists one on, it bounces just wide of Kavanaugh's net, and Clarkstown unable to clear. Campbell steps in front of it. Chasing it down was Torrey. Into the side it comes, and now still unable to clear was Clarkson. Finally, the puck comes back behind the net, and Clarkstown is able to retrieve it back behind the net.
What pressure by Mamaroneck here.
They still are able to keep it in. What a shift. Carducci, Schreiber, twistled it wide, might have been deflected, or he might not have gotten a clean shot off. Payne back at the point. Tried centering one. Carducci gets free to go chase it down in the far side corner. Now Torrey, back behind the net it comes to Schreiber. Playing it there is Murray. The Clarkstown defenders are absolutely exhausted. They still can't clear. Campbell out in front it comes.
Penalty coming.
And, well, yeah, you knew that was bound to happen at some point. It's a high sticking call. You just cannot continue to play defense for that long. The Clarkstown defenders had absolutely nothing left after a terrific shift. It's a high sticking call. Against Shane Murphy, and Mamaroneck will go on the power play.
As that was a minute and a half, almost 2 minutes of constant pressure in the zone. Basically, right after the goal, they got it, and they were pressuring Clarkstown, and they nearly scored two or three times. And
the faceoff is won back to the point. This is Payne. Payne walks the point, shoots, deflected, and a save made by Kavanaugh. Now Dente gets it back to the point. Campbell back to Dente. 4 minutes left to go in regulation. This is Payne. Out in front. That shot was gloved on a shot by Harris, by Dente. And we'll have a stoppage and a whistle with 1:09 left to go on this Mamaroneck power play.
Nice pass by Payne to Dente, and a good bouncing shot and a good save by Kavanaugh to keep it 3-1.
Tigers win the draw back to Payne. Over to Campbell. Campbell gets it back at the point. Over to Payne now. Under a minute left to go on the power play. Payne's shot was blockered aside by Kavanaugh, and Mamaroneck able to retain possession. On the far side, it's DeSico. And Campbell.
Another
Payne.
Penalty.
Another penalty upcoming, and Mamaroneck should give up the puck here because they'll get a two-man advantage, although now the extra attacker is James Torrey. He's on the ice. So now a 6-on-4 advantage for Mamaroneck with 33 seconds left on the initial penalty. Spin move by Payne. Payne continues to dance with it, and he shoots one. It was deflected by a defenseman, and now Clarkstown touches up. So Mamaroneck will have 22 seconds of a 5-on-3 with 3:05 left in regulation, and Clarkstown is now in deep, deep trouble.
That was a tripping penalty, it looked like, on the captain, Diskin. Actually, interference. Second penalty of the game on Diskin. As that said, it'll be 5-on-3. But they cost themselves about 20 seconds of 5-on-3 hockey.
But they did have a 6-on-4 because the goaltender came out of the extra attacker. So you still do get the two-man advantage. Either way, it did work out for Mamaroneck. Plus, at this point, the big issue is you want to kill some time. And so Mamaroneck was able to hang onto the puck for those extra 20 seconds. So Payne back to get it. 10 seconds left in the 5-on-3. This is Carducci. Carducci swings wide as Mamaroneck sets it up. Payne walks the point, walks into the slot. Centers one out in front. It was taken by Clarkstown and sent the length of the ice. Minute left on the penalty, 2:34 left in regulation. Tigers lead it 3-1 here in the Section 1 quarterfinals. This is Torrey. Torrey into the offensive zone, passes back for Schreiber. Schreiber wings it behind the net. Now Carducci into the corner. Carducci back to Payne. Payne walks the point. His pass was deflected, and the Mamaroneck student section is beginning to feel a win. The short chant was, start the buses.
Yep,
this
yep.
is Torrey. Into the offensive zone comes Mamaroneck. Under 2 minutes left in regulation. That centering feed, nobody was there, but it's taken by Lee. Lee over to Knowles. Knowles wrists one on a save made by Kavanaugh, and he hangs on with 12 seconds left on the power play and a minute 46 left in the game.
And you allow them to keep the goalie in. If they didn't have a power play and it was 5-on-5, they might have pulled them with 2.5, 3 minutes, because you want as much advantage as you can, but since they're defending a penalty, you can't do that. So you have another 12 seconds of the penalty, and you're down 2 goals, too.
Clarkstown able to control it. The penalty is over.
One more second.
And now Mamaroneck able to control it with 90 seconds left. It's turned over, though. This is Ryder. That shot was deflected well wide. Ryder, the only goal scorer. That one Spiro wasn't ready for, and he saved it anyways on the shot by Diskin. Minute 15 left to go. There goes Kavanaugh. Empty net for Clarkstown.
A little late getting on as the extra skater here, Murphy.
LeBlanc bounces it off the boards, and it's going to go wide of the empty net with 1:01 left to go.
Wow, Seth. That was inches wide. That was like knock hockey, the way they played that. Did LeBlanc, he just wanted to get it out of the zone. It wasn't even a shot, really.
Clarkstown scored the game's first goal in the first period. They took a 1-0 lead into the first intermission. Mamaroneck, 3 unanswered goals since then. Clarkstown has way too many guys on the ice right now. Well, they had 7, now they have 6 with the extra attacker, and now they call timeout. With 1:01 left to go, Tigers, 3 unanswered goals, hold a 3-1 advantage with 61 seconds between them and a bid in the Section 1, Division 1 semifinals. So Mamaroneck allowed 10 shots on goal in the first period, 6 in the second. The Tigers have allowed only 2 shots all period, and they're now less than 1 minute away from advancing to the semifinals. Puck is loose in the Tigers' defensive end. Clarkstown needs to hurry. This is Murphy, who passed it across. That shot was blocked by the defense. Puck is taken by Mamaroneck. This is Torrey. Torrey towards the empty net. He scores! And with 39.2 to go, James Torrey puts it on ice. A 2-point game for him. A 4-1 lead for Mamaroneck. And they are on their way to the Section 1, Division 1 semifinals.
Nick Campbell gets the second assist, first assist to Harrison Schreiber, so he has a goal and an assist in the game. And the Mamaroneck 4-1, as back in goal is the senior Kavanaugh after the empty netter by Torrey, which I could have put in the goal
it
there.
It was a valiant effort by Clarkstown tonight. They played Mamaroneck awfully tough, but ultimately too much Mamaroneck down the stretch, second and third periods. As the Tigers with 4 unanswered goals, 20 seconds left now. And the defending state champions have won what Mike Schiaparelli likes to say is the hardest one to get, is the first sectional playoff game. And this one is 5 seconds away from being in the books. Tigers allow 3 shots in the third period, and they are moving on to the Section 1, Division 1 semifinals here at the Hamex Park Ice Rink. We will have that game for you. It'll be played on Friday night here at Hamex.
As they will face the winner of North Rockland and White Plains. But it should be a good game, as we'll be back with post-game interviews and analysis.
And this was a night when, for Mamaroneck, I think, they needed to battle through this game. They needed to battle through it. They needed to find a way. As you see the two goaltenders there shaking hands, and Tommy Spiro with some nice words for Tim Kavanaugh as the handshake line begins. Mamaroneck really needed to battle through this game to find a way to get the win, and they were able to do that, and because of that, they are indeed on their way to the Section 1 semifinal. So lots more still to do here at Hammocks. We'll have some post-game interviews. We'll talk to Coach Mike Schiaparelli as the Tigers are moving on here at Hammocks. We're back in just a moment. Stay right there. All right, back in the postgame, James Torrey joining us now. 4-1 Tigers win, and that first period, you guys trailing 1-0. What changed after that opening period?
I mean, we know Clarkstown comes really hard in the first period. We played them twice this year, and they always came out really hard. We knew the rest of the game was ours, and we just came out with more intensity, and we got the first one, and it just kept coming. It was great.
You guys, obviously, the defending state champions. How much nerves is there right now as you try to defend this?
I mean, there's a lot of nerves with a lot of new guys on the team. Our goal is obviously the state championship, but we're taking one game at a time, and we're taking it slow and trying to get every game going and getting shots every game. It's working out well.
As you guys are defending that lead in the third period, you really held Clarkstown down. Why were you able to be so effective?
I mean, we have played Clarkstown twice, and we know their systems, and we know what they're good at, and we know their best players, and we just were able to eliminate them and work our systems, and we just kept getting goals, and it was working for us.
Back here on the postgame show with Brian Carducci, and Brian, it was a good win for you guys. What was the mentality after the 1-0 deficit in the locker room there?
I'd say just to keep calm and come together as a team. I'd say from last year, we were used to it. We went down against Scarsdale last year, and we maintained our focus and got back to the basics.
And that was some goal you scored. Tell me about that, that you deflected it and it like flopped in the air and then it landed at your feet and you sniped it past the goalie there.
I'd say what we did in the second period definitely caused that goal. We started forechecking really hard in the second period, not as much in the first, but second period when we forechecked hard, we forced some turnovers and turnover up in the high slot, turned around, shot at far side and went in.
And as the number one seed, you have a target on your back, also as the defending state champs. How do you not allow you guys have to play even better because teams are coming after you?
I'd say just take one game at a time, focus period by period, shift by shift, and just go as far as we can as a team.
And in the next game, now that you have one playoff game under your belt, how do you think you guys will handle your next game, maybe not as be as slow in that first period?
I'd say I think we know. The new guys in our team kind of know what it's like to be in a playoff experience and really intense atmosphere, and I think we're back to normal.
All right, back in the post-game show, Coach Mike Schiaparelli joins us now. And Coach, you guys are down 1-0 after one. What changed going into that second period?
Well, we had to come out and finish our forecheck. We were backing off, not going hard enough and through them. And then we had to start throwing the puck on the net and have a guy go to the net because he's giving rebounds up. And we got one right away off a rebound. Gave us some confidence. Came out shooting well, then we took a little break again. They're good at clogging the zones. A smart, very well-coached team. And they got a great goalie, too. This is the hardest game for us to play because we had a quality opponent off a bye. They're coming off a win, coming up feeling good about themselves, and we were here waiting around for 9 days practicing. So to get this one out of the way, even though the opponents get harder, this was a harder game to play. We'll play better in the next games.
We're standing right under that state championship, you know, banner. Is there pressure for this team in trying to play after that right now?
I don't think they're thinking about it, but I think the other teams are trying to knock that banner out of their tournament. So the other team puts pressure on themselves to try and do it. Our kids just come out to play and try to play with some composure. So we're trying it out. We did a pretty good job. We made some bad passes at times. I thought we sat back a little bit at times and didn't come back and help break the breakout. So made those corrections and did a little better after that.
North Rockland won today, so they will be your opponent in your semifinal game. What do you know about them and what do you have to do to beat them?
Hey, we beat them on February 10th, not too long ago, 6-0. We got to work hard. They have some quality players. We got to work hard. We got to throw again on that team. We got to throw in the net and get rebounds with their goal.
All right, back here on the postgame show, Tigers win it by a 4-1 final score. Charlie McGraw, Seth Rothman with you. And, you know, Charlie, this was the kind of game, as Coach Schiaparelli said, it is a difficult game for them to play. He says that every time it's your first playoff game. I thought Mamaroneck a little bit pensive in that first period, really came out strong in the second period, and then a lockdown performance in the third period on their way to a win.
Yeah, just the first period jitters for them, and Clarkstown outplayed them badly, and then they responded with the two goals. Michael Carducci with a great goal, which was the game-winning goal, because that made it 2-1, and just a great second period and third period, and got to give it to Coach Schiaparelli, whatever he said in the locker room, and the guys who hadn't played in the playoffs before, their jitters were gone, and it looked like the varsity B team in the first period, and the second period was the Mamaroneck team we've seen all season.
And again, you know, this is a Mamaroneck team that I think kind of thrives on on emotion and on playing well and on playing hard. And you really saw that in the last half an hour of that game. It was all Mamaroneck, especially defensively. They really locked things down. Clarkstown only had 3 shots in the entire third period. And offense might win games, defense wins championships, and Mamaroneck is going for their 2nd straight state championship.
Yeah, because it was all in the defensive zone was that period. There was about 2 minutes straight where it was just in that zone, and they drew a penalty. They drew another penalty after that, and then that eventually they couldn't pull the goalie until a minute and a half, even though they were down by 2 goals. And when they did pull him, Mamaroneck scored like 45 seconds later to make it 4-1, and it was done by that point. But it was just a great job to get it in that zone and put them on the defensive side. And that was the Mamaroneck we saw all season. And they just really played so much better in the second and third period. That first period, they hadn't played in a week, and it was something we weren't used to seeing. But they handled the adversity very well, Seth.
They certainly did. And now they move on to the Section 1 Division 1 semifinals. North Rockland beating White Plains 8-5. So it'll be North Rockland here at the Homics Park Ice Rink. And you can see that game here on LMC TV next weekend. So for the entire team here at LMC and for Charlie McGraw, I'm Seth Rothman saying thanks for watching. And we will see you next time right here on LMC Varsity Sports.